Right, welcome back everybody. Hopefully you're all well. I was requested to do a follow-up video on weathering of wagons. Now, lots of people have done this on the internet and I'm no expert. I just use a few techniques I've seen around, adapted them and come up with a solution using a variety of off-the-shelf paints and pigments to hopefully give a reasonable effect of rust. These are old Airfix plastic wagons, and these are actually in the grey plastic unpainted, and I've weathered these on top of the plastic with pigments and sprayed the internals and wheel sets underneath. The sprung buffers are from a Curascale. Cut off the original Airfix ones, which look a bit clunky, and I've cut off the pivot points down here because there's a large working pivot. I may add in a small bit of wire to represent the hinge. I haven't quite got around to doing that. I've also got some Brassmaster etched hooks to go in. Now I'm probably going to do those off screen because I'm probably going to heat them up and burn them in, someone suggested to me. I'll see how I get on with that. So I'll film that separately perhaps. So that's the Airfix wagon. This is a standard Backman wagon. It's second hand. It's got a bit of corrosion to the buffers. This is the same type of wagon I did some weathering on yesterday. And I probably went a bit overboard with the dirt a little bit. And I'm going to show you how to weather these with a similar sort of chipping effect that I gained around these edges. The paints I'm using is Citadel Typhus Corrosion, a series of Ammo or MIG browns and blacks, which came in this nice little kit. I'll leave a link for that. And then I have some AK Interactive. This is an aircraft set. It's cheaper to buy them in a set of three. A series of washes and grease, etc. These I think are more enamel based. I use those for doing some detailing work. A brush, and then also an AK Interactive Rust Streaks, which takes a little bit of work to get the correct streaks. There is an AK Interactive tutorial somewhere. If I can find the YouTube link, I will add that as well. Okay, so let's see if we can get started. What I first off have done in the past is I've weathered with an airbrush with some browns and blacks the inside and a bit of the running gear. These are quite nicely corroded, just normal corrosion, these metal buffers. So I'm gonna paint those brown and see how I get on. A bit of moisture on here with the brushes. Move that away. I'll move these ones out of the way. Just for reference, this is a pre-weathered Backman wagon, which seems to have had some dots spray airbrushed on and dusting over the top. The dusting over the top actually just blends things in a little bit. So whether you actually do coal streaks or muck or dust, it does give an overall toning down of the rust. So this one was quite vibrant before I put some coal streaks on it with weathering powders, and I'll just brush those down with a little bit of enamel thinners. I may take some off, we'll see how we get on. And then so shall we start? I'm in a rather large room. I normally do this in a ventilated fan, spray booth. I'm going to use a small amount of paint. That's acrylic, water based. I'll start off with rust. Could be brown. Let's put a couple of drops of that in. There's some black in here as well, so I'm going to give it a mixed up. I'm spraying with the nozzle tip guard off. This is a 0.3 brush, I believe. I think it's about £15 on eBay or Amazon. It's not an expensive brush, but I find it's quite fine. So if I take the tip off, spray closely. Spray that on the inside. Slightly dark brown. Just a couple of drops. Need lots of paint. It's probably more on the tissue than it's actually on the model. Going into the centre of the wagon, and I'm just going randomly. I'm trying to make sure the paint goes in the wagon, nowhere else. Double action airbrush, I'll just push the air in, spin the wheel up, and then a little bit of paint in. board on. So, where do I pick it up? Got a light dusting of brown, two different browns in there, though it looks fairly even of one. And then the same on the undercarriage, there's a little bit of brown on the wheels, and a little bit on the springs and axle boxes. Not too much actually on the sole bar, and there's a bit on the buffers just to cover up that corrosion anyway. So being acrylic, it dries fairly quickly, touch dry. To add some more feature on the inside, weathering powders, but that's a bit later on. So I'm going to go on to the chipping technique that I've used on the outside. And I'm not sure I'm going to get this all done in one video. We'll see where we go. So what I have here is the dust effect. You can use a light grey enamel. But I just use this and it gives the edging around the rust. Let's see if we can find a bit. So you can just see here, there's just a little bit of edge of what looks like chip paint around the rust. I'll attempt to replicate that with this without washing it off at a later date. And what we simply do is at random is we chip. Probably a little bit big. Being quite light, it's probably about two or three shades too light. But the advantage of that is when you actually put the coal weathering effects on, it turns it down quite a lot. You go for a darker colour, but then it'd be less obvious. It's one of my favourite brushes. It's a 00 Winsor & Newton. Last time I went in the range, they were £2.99. Going the light chips. When you look at lots of photos of these wagons, some of them have all the edges chipped and the panels are fairly clear, and others have all the panels chipped and the edges not, which seems a bit bizarre. But we'll see how we go. So the doors are often very rusty, so I did before. It's gonna be the last one I get hold of. I completely rusted the door up. So we'll see how we go. Shall we try that one? What I'm doing here is just an outline of the rust patch. It's probably a little bit too much. And it looks quite severe at the moment, but when you fight through with the brown with the acrylics, it kind of disappears. On some of these, I've actually put the transfers on top of the rust effect. So you kind of get a bubbly transfer. Quite often you see this is just chipped straight through. Try and be random with the paint as well. It's not too even. It looks a bit artificial. Beautiful factory finish, lovingly applied by Backman, and we're just messing it up or enhancing it. Fine line between the two, I think. Tend to get a lot down here on the lower flap. There's other techniques as well, the sponges, chipping with chip medium. Tried those as well. And they're quite time consuming. This can quite be therapeutic. Let that dry. Doing here is I'm just painting it quite randomly, but if I do a streak on the inside, I do it vertically. I'll go for the corners a little bit. is another colour. Going over with a bit of a lighter brown in the centre. Let's come back and put some more city decoration on if you need to. Right in the centre of that.
Seems like it's working with you. Rules to explain to. Rules to explain to. Even the secrets are getting worse just about rises. So many different shades. what colour he is. What starts to look like this?
But just to recap, we've put on a lighter colour of an enamel, we've put on some typhus corrosion, and we've put on a variety of the MIG ammo set browns. There's quite a few. You should just vary these for each wagon. And we've got a based effect now on the wagon. And what I'm going to do is add some rust streaks. Here I have a small amount of humble thinners. Get a bit closer. Going to do is just put small drops. Once again, try and go for the centre of the previous colours. If you want, at any stage, you can. If you're happy with where you are with the model, you can always seal. A layer in with some matte varnish, and at any point where you're not quite happy, go in with a cotton bud and a small amount of thinners, enamel thinners, and just wipe it off to move the material around on the surface. The more tones you put on, the better they affect generally. Obviously, the more time it takes to consume, the more time it takes to produce a wagon. And there you go. So, flat wide brush, thinners on it, wipe the majority of the thinners off, and then gently streak down. Keep those strokes as straight as possible. See, it's just starting to streak. Oh, wobbled there, that's no good. You have to be careful you don't wipe off the lighter enamels doing this. Not quite got the effect you want. A little bit more on. Probably best just to work in a quadrant at a time. Thank you. quite over the top. Let's just take a little bit more off. The more time you take on it, the better the result. Just following the dots where I was before. If there's any area you're not quite happy with and you want to add a little bit more in, more texture, darken it up a little bit with the various paints. In the centre here is leftover weathering powder from the previous workings. What I'm going to do is a little dab weathering powders in. Now you can apply these dry, apply them with a bit of thinners. I don't normally put the wet brush in, but if we go two over the top, flash off a little bit. So all we're going to do is just gently, once again, just strokes. Just some more rust. Put some more rust in. You want to tease the rust down and pluck it off its way. You can always add a little bit more powders. Tend to use these around the springs. I think this is more acting like a filter than a not wash. It's just gives the impression of a slightly darker look to the wagon. Once again, you don't particularly want the pigments to pool. If you find it pools in a puddle and then struggle to film this, I do apologise. Then you just want to move it around until it evaporates. worst things left is with actually a sideward swirl. Looks unnatural. Get the wagon too wet, you'll end up brushing off your previous pigments.